Vande Gurupada Dandam Bhaktavinda Samannitam Sri Chaitanya Prabhum Vande Nitta Ananda Sahoditam Sri Nanda Nandanang Vande Radhika Charanadayam Gopijano Samayuktam Vrindavanam Manoharam Vāñśā-kalpataru-asya-kipāsindhu-vevaj patitānaṁ pāvunibhva-vaiṣṇavibhyo namo namah mūkaṁ karoti vācālaṁ paṅgoṁ laṁ haitigiriṁ yat-kipātam-haṅga-bandhi-paramānanda-mādhavam vindhāvai-kūsidhe-vai-piyāvi-keśa-vasacu Śrīna-bhakti-pade-devī-sattva-vattvai-namo Narayana namaskritta naranchaiva narottamam Devim Saraswatim vyasam tato jayo mudiret Sankirtane Krishna kathopadeshe Gauriya patrasya prakasanecha Sadanurakta guru bhakti yukta Bhakti pramadaksha jagod varunya Dhyam sada paribhavagna bhavishtaduham Tethaspadam siva viranjinutam saranyam Bhetatiham panutopal bhavadiputam Bande mahapurusate charanarvindam Yatpada pallavanaka chandamani chataya Vishpurjita kimapikapavadushvadarshi Purna nuragara sasagara saramurti saradhikamai kadam kivam karoshi. Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhara Sivasadi Gaura Bhakta Binda Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Siyadvaita Gadadhara Sivasadihi Gaura Bhakta Binda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Ajānulambita bhujau kanukā bodhātu Sankirtanai kavitaro kamalā yatākṣa Vishāmbaro dijavaro jugadharma pālo Bande jagat priyakaro karunā bhataro Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Namami Gange Tava Pad Pankajam Sura Surair Vandito Dibha Rupam Bhuktin Cha Muktin Cha Dada Sinitam Bhavanurupena sadhanaranam Ganga taranga ramaniya jata kalafam Gauri nirantara vibhushita bham bhagam Narayana priyamananga madapuharam Varanasi purapati bhajavi shanatham Bhagi Sajusha Badane Lakshmi Rajasa Chavakshasi Jasyasthi De Sambhir Vam Nishinga Mahambhaji Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare vadanti tat tattva vidastvatvam yad jnanam adyam brahmeti paramatmeti bhagavaniti sabdati vadanti tat tattva vidastvatvam yad jnanam adyam brahmeti paramatmeti bhagavaniti sabdati Gauriya Gashtipati Srisila Bhakti Siddhanta Swaraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada Jagat Guru said that logical interpretation cannot stand in the way of that absolute truth. Gauriya Gashtipati Srisila Bhakti Siddhanta Swaraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada Jagat Guru told that logical interpretation cannot stand in the way of that absolute truth. This absolute truth is Advaita Gyana Tattva, which is an unique Advaita Gyana Tattva, that is the absolute Tattva Vastu. This being the absolute object, those sages call this to be the ultimate attainable absolute goal. Param Paramartha, that Tattva Vastu is known as Brahma or Paramatma or Bhagavan. These three different way of expression is there, or terminology. Our finite conception can never understand this absolutely infinity tattva. That absolute tattva, that infinity tattva vastu, we cannot understand. Our finite conception can never understand this absolute tattva, this infinity tattva, or Advaita Gyana tattva. So somehow, to understand this absolute tattva vastu, we are always habituated in this material world to look back into our material experience bank to get support of our logical interpretation. That is a main disease. We know the following sloka from Shastra about Supreme Divinity. What is that? It is written, Kartum akartum annatha kartum ya samarthaha sa eva ishvara. Kartum akartum annatha kartum ya samarthaha sa ishvara. Sa eva ishvara. He is, definitely he is Supreme Lord. Who can do everything? What he cannot do? What he cannot do, that is the question. He can do everything. Everything is possible for him. So he is Supreme Divinity, Supreme Lord. In Bhagavatam also it is written, Kim alabhya tayi prasanne, Ho God, Ho Supreme Lord, Bhagavan, if you become satisfied with me, what I cannot get? Everything is possible for me. What is not possible for me to attain? Everything is. Kim alabhya tayi prasanni. The previous log where I am speaking, kartum akartum annatha kartum ya samarthaha sa eva ishvara. He is the sir who can do everything. What is not possible? Everything is possible for him. That is, but still, according to tattva, we will have to understand this. That is called actually when I can believe Supreme Lord 100%, that everything is possible for him. This kind of 100% belief in Supreme Lord is called actually Saranagati. It is called actually 100% same person believe in Supreme Lord. But we cannot believe 100%. We believe, but 100% we cannot believe. We have some doubt, we have some question, different kind of, you know, You know, we cannot understand. Bhagavan can do this, but Bhagavan cannot do that thing. It is called half faith, half belief in Supreme Lord. Bhagavan can do this, but Bhagavan cannot. It is not possible for Bhagavan to do that. I mean, when I am going to believe Supreme Lord half, 50%, that's why you can remember, many times Prabhupada used to speak that more or less we are contaminated with Mayavad Vichar. We are all Mayavadi, more or less, not that 100%. More or less we are contaminated with Mayavad Vichar. If I can believe Supreme Lord 50%, if he cannot believe Guru Vishnu 100%, in that case, contamination is there. Supreme Lord can make us half believe, if we cannot believe 100% about Almighty, All Powerful Supreme Lord, Omnipresent Supreme Lord, then we are contaminated with Mayavar Vichar. What is not possible? I can give example, after that I can go on discussing about how karma become anadi. How jiva become anadi baddha. Only philosophy is not good. Because you will have to understand, na? Follow. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking. That if I try to understand, I cannot understand. But if I go on doing bhajan under the guidance of very, very pure Guru Vaishnava who can give me realization power, Bhaktivinoda Thakur is going to use this word, Chit Samadhi. Bhaktivinoda Thakur is going to use it, going to use this word, Chit Samadhi. Oh man, if you stop argument, if you go on doing Harinam and Harikatha, go on doing hearing, very shortly, before long, you can realize, if you go into Chit Samadhi, meditation, you can realize how it is possible. A prakita time period, the eternal, any material time. I like to discuss, but by all of your mercy, I like to discuss all. Under the guidance of Baladev Vidyabhushan, Vishwanath Chakravartipad, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Prabhupada, I like to discuss under their guidance all the time. Now, one or two examples first I can give. After that, how karma is anadi, how baddhaji is anadi, bahirmukh, I like to discuss this point. After that, eternal time, material time, all gradually, I like to discuss. Because so many questions coming about, they cannot understand. It is quite natural they cannot understand. It is quite natural because to understand something relating to that aprakita jagat, I will have to stop my argument, I will have to do bhajan, I have to depend upon the power of Gurudev, Guru Kepa Hi Kevalam. 100% by the mercy of Sadguru, very powerful, Nityananda representative, can give everything, all realization. How it is possible? Now one or two examples first I can give. After that you can understand that what is not possible for Krishna. One or two examples first I like to give. An example can be given from Bhagavatam. You can remember that Rasa Leela, or duration of Rasa Leela, was one Kalpakal, Brahmaratra Vapi. Brahmaratra. What I mean to say, Bhagavan can put kalpakal time, Bhagavan can put kalpakal time inside the small you know, gapping space of a fraction of second. Do you believe or not? Bhagavan can put a total kalpakal time inside a small gapping space of a fraction of second. Within that fraction of second, Bhagavan can put kalpakal. Is possible or not? Because the duration of Rasa Leela was Brahmaratra, total, the time period during which Brahma is sleeping. Brahmaratra, you cannot calculate, so big time, big amount. But within the twinkling of eyes, fraction of second, that Rasa Leela was over, as was felt by Gopikas. This was the feeling of those Gopikas. Also, you can remember that within that big gapping of time, of that abnormal time factor, big time period, those husbands of those Gopikas, those who are actually married, those who are not married, I'm not speaking there, those husbands of those Gopikas, they could not even realize this havoc time gapping within their one night of sleeping habit. Not only that, but also none of them, I mean no husband, could realize that wife was not there at bed, left side. He already gone to participate in Rasa Leela dance with Bhagavan Sri Krishna. That's why Sukadeva Goswami is speaking in front of Parikshit Maharaj that they could not express any envious attitude to Krishna. Why? Na asuyana khalu krishnayo mahitastasya mayaya mannamana sapasasthana sana sana darana brajaukasaha. Na asuyana khalu krishnayo mahitastasya mayaya mannamana sapasasthana sana sana darana brajaukasaha. Those Brajavasis, I mean, husbands of those Gopikas, they couldn't realize. They thought everything okay. Follow. One or two examples I can give. That is also very excellent example. How it is possible? You can remember when Revati Devi, I mean, the Shakti of Baldevji Maharaj. When Revati Devi was taken in front of Brahmaji in Brahma Loka, when Revati Maiya was taken in front of Brahmaji in Brahma Loka by Revat Raja, his father, her father, it was in Satya Yuga. Then Brahma, that time, was busy in a sabha. He was busy. So he had to wait. He was bound to wait to meet with him, with Brahma, to ask about Revati Devi's marriage, to talk about the topics of marriage of Revati, with whom I can give my daughter away in marriage. But then the sabha was when the sabha was over, then it was late. But when the sabha was over, then it was too late to ask about the suitable candidate for Revati Devi, because by that time period gapping of Brahma at Brahma Loka, here in this Martha Loka material world, then it was Dapar Yug. I mean, Satya Yug gone, Teta Yug gone, and Dapar Yug late, almost end. So you see the relative time factors there at Brahma Loka and here in Martha Loka, relative. You try to understand, I know it is impossible to understand. Whole world, infinity world is relative world. Relative. So So you see the relative time factors there in Brahmaloka, here in Marturoka. Really, this is a great astonishing factor. Relative world can make fool of us, each and every fraction of second. The whole infinity cosmic manifestation full of relative, you know, diversity. Diversity is a relative diversity, not like eternal world. But regarding eternal Jagat, we should not have this kind of relative conception, because there is only eternal present tense following, only eternal present. Present tense. Only eternal present tense flowing there. No past or no present tense, which is impossible for you and me to understand. Follow. Here in this material world, if I am going to pronounce this word present, P-R-E-A-C-N-T, if I am going to pronounce this word present, P-R-E-A-C-N-T, within fraction of second when I am speaking P-R-E-S, and each and every fraction of second when I pronounce P gone into the account of past. P gone to past. R gone to past. E gone to past. This way, if you very, very in cool brain, if you try to understand, almost nothing is present. Everything here in this material are all of past. Follow what I say. Past or future. Present, this conception is so fine demarcation, we cannot cut. Follow. We are going to extend this word. I am staying here, you are staying here. So, then with the pronunciation of P already gone in the account of past tense. This is the status of our present tense in this material world. With this material brain and mind, if we try to pass any remark about eternal time factor there in the transcendental abode, then it will be a great mistake on our part. I can discuss this point. Those aprakita Guru Vaishnav like Rupa Goswami Pad, Sanatan Goswami Pad, Raghunath Das Goswami, Jiva Goswami Pad, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Srila Saraswati Thakur, Prabhupada, etc. Everyone. Those were our previous Saraswati Gauri Guru Varga, these were coming for eternal, they are coming from eternal world. So they have their practical experience about that. So they can speak about eternal time factor. Our speculation, our judgment, all useless. Because bonded souls are always full of four different kind of defects with their material mind, intellect, together with all defective sense organs, everything. So there is every possibility of mistake on the part of those bonded soul. Brahmo pramad vipralipsa karna patap. Nobody here in this material world is free of this, you know. Follow. This is our condition. This is our condition. Now I can discuss about this aprakita samaya, time. Because I already read that letter written by you, one of my son. You wanted to give so nice judgment. Really. I was very happy to see that there is somebody who is thinking so deeply. I'm very happy. Your explanation can deserve wide acclamation. No doubt in it. Your explanation can deserve wide acclamation, no doubt. I too was really happy to see your, you know, hard effort to establish proper Siddhanta, but sorry, I am sorry to speak that never we can establish proper Siddhanta that way. Follow? I am very sorry to speak, never mind. But never we can establish proper Siddhanta that way. Your judgment was very good, but that way we can never establish proper Siddhanta. We'll have to, then what to do? We will have to go into deep meditation through our bhajan power, by the mercy of all of our previous, our Guru Varga, by the causeless mercy, of our Guru Varga, we can realize what is what. Because that is transcendental world, that is material world. Many times I told what Prabhupada used to speak, that this material world is a perverted reflection of the transcendental world. This material world is a perverted reflection of the transcendental world. By the grace of Gauriya Guru Varga, our previous Guru Varga, we can find solution very easily. But our personal effort without bhajan power cannot unveil the mystery. We cannot understand. One or two examples I can give. Excuse me. I was very happy to see your argument. Very happy. I was reading it very carefully. But sometimes I was laughing. This way we cannot establish a Prakita Siddhanta. Not possible. Like the case of Advaita Gosai, who is Mahavishnu, Jagatkarta, Mayaya, Jasijati, Adaha, Tashyavatara, Eva, Ayam, Advaita Acharya Iswaraha. You can remember. Chaitanya Bhagavad, Chaitanya, you can go, you can find, Chaitanya, especially in Chaitanya Bhagavad, like the case of Advaita Gosai, I like to give. Who, when cannot understand the real meaning of any particular Gita sloka, simply this is one kind of leela. Don't think Advaita Gosai is foolish. He is Mahavishnu, non-different from Supreme Lord, but still doing this kind of leela. So I have the advantage to consult this point. So like the case of Advaita Gosai, who, when cannot understand the real meaning of any particular Gita sloka, he used to depend upon the causeless mercy of Supreme Lord. He used to fast without water, without prasadam, he is fasting. He used to fast. Though we know it very well, he is, you know, Sadasiva Tatta, who is non-different from Mahavishnu. But still, this kind of lila done by him for our absolute benefit, so that we can never go for logical interpretation. Argument we can stop, that's why. This kind of lila done by him for our absolute benefit, Mangal. Follow. And it is there in Chaitanya Bhagavat, Bhagavan coming in dream and saying, Advaita, get up, take prasadam. This is the meaning of this sloka is this. Then Advaita goes and dancing and taking prasadam, going to, you know, do everything. This is a leela. So what about us? We are all bonded so. Also the case of Harivallabh, I mean Srila Vishwanath Chakravartipad. When he was, this case can be considered, when he could not understand the perfect and full meaning of Kama Gayatri, which is comprising of 24 and a half syllable, you know. He also took absolute shelter unto the lotus feet of Srimati Radharani. the absolute divine master. Follow. He was also fasting at the bank of Radhakunda. He said, I cannot take any water and prasadam because I know from Shastra that mantra and mantra devata, mantra and mantra devata, for whom this mantra is there? Mantra and mantra devata is non-different from each other. Follow what I say. Mantra and mantra devata all non-different from each other. That's why if I cannot understand Kama Gayatri is comprising of 24 and a half, you know, syllable, then surely I cannot get darshan of Kamdev. So it is good for me to go for fasting. I can die. He also took shelter, absolute shelter, unto the lotus feet of Srimati Radharani, that absolute divine master. Srimati Radharani came in dream and told clearly that my Priyanarma Sakhi, Kasturi Manjari, Srila Krishnadas Kaviraj, can never make any mistake. Be sure about it. He cannot make any mistake. Anna. Who has compiled this siege? See, in Chaitanya Charitamrita, this Kama Gayatri, Aprakita Kama Gayatri, and he was going to, you know, make some explanation about that 24 and a half word, syllable. He can never make any mistake, be sure about it. You can consult Varnabhigamat, one book. You can consult Varnabhigamat book to trace out the perfect reason of selection of half syllable. By the help of this grammatical technique, Srila Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami has done this explanation of full Kama Gayatri, comprising of 24 and a half syllable. This way, finally, he got solution. Previously he was in full tension and anxiety about the complete understanding of Kama Gayatri, because without understanding Kama Gayatri mantra, one cannot meet with mantra devata. This way, one by one, we can have so many examples to get full satisfaction about how it is, how to avoid logical interpretation or altercation. This way we can get. Also, we know from Shastra, Chaitanya Charitamrita, aprakita vastu ko bhu prakita gochar nahi. Aprakita vastu, which is aprakita vastu, material people with material brain and conception cannot get entry into this matter of aprakita vastu. As and when they can get entry into aprakita jagat, they can understand. Aprakita vastu kabhu prakita gochar nahi. Again from Mahabharata Bhishma Parva we can find one other sloka. Achinta khalu je bhava na tang starke na jojayet. Prakriti bhyo param jaccha tad achintasya lakshanam. Mahabharata Bhishma Parva, there is one sloka, very often we used to write it and speak it. Achinta khalu je bhava na tang starke na jojayet. Prakriti bhyo param jaccha. Tad achintasya lakshanam. About achinta bhava, logical interpretation is strictly prohibited. Because those are surely Aprakita Jagat is surely beyond human comprehension, beyond human comprehension. So we cannot understand. Also from Chaitanya Charitamrita we know Madhyakhanda, that Sarvam Bhattacharya was busy fighting with Gopinath Acharya about the understanding of the Supreme Divinity of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He was not ready to understand his Supreme. No, no, no. Sriman Gopinath Acharya, you know, Srimad Gopinath Acharya was trying his best to give understanding to Sarvam Bhattacharya. But Sarvam Bhattacharya was not at all ready to understand. Follow. From Chaitanya Charitamrita, Madhyakanda 82, Madhyakanda 6, chapter 82-87, we can discuss. Also from there we can see the advice of Sriman Gopinath Acharya, you know, to Sarvam Bhattacharya. He was going to give some argument, I mean, vichar, to Sarvam Bhattacharya, who is a great Mayavadi Pandit, he was, who was expressing doubt about the Supreme Divinity of Sri Krishna Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He was not at all ready. Gopinath Acharya was giving so many arguments from Shastra. Even he was ready to speak. There is no avatar in Kalikal. How you say avatar? How I know? He is, you know, Chaitanya Devi, Chaitanya, you know, he is, you know, Sri Krishna Chaitanya, he is Bhagavan. I am not ready. Is giving argument, then Gopinath Acharya was bound to speak. Anuman praman nahi ishvat tattva gyane, kipa bina ishvat tattva keho nahi jane. Logical intermediate assumption is totally prohibited. Assumption cannot stand. Anuman praman nahi, assumption is not document praman about ishvat tattva. So when you are going to get kripa from Ishwar, when Bhagavan going to give you kripa, follow. When Bhattajib going to try and Bhagavan going to help both, when in that case we can come out successful, like the case of Yashodama. Yashodama repeatedly tried to tie up Gopal. Damodar like to tie Gopal. Yashodama like to put in bondage, rope bondage, but she is failure. Repeatedly, Yashodama trying her best, but she is failure. Ultimately, it is written in Bhagavatam, Kripaya Asit Savandhani. Gopal, Kripaya, Kripaya Asit. Gopal automatically himself become merciful and he allowed Yashodama to bind him. Follow. Then she was successful. Then Vishwanatha Chakravarti was writing, Bhattajib can express different kind of desire, but without the Ishwarer Kipabina, fall nahi dhare. Bhattajib, bonded soul, can express different kind of desire, but Ishwar going to help, then we can come out successful. Anuman praman nahi ishvat tattva gyane, kipa bina ishvat tattva keho nahi jane. Follow. Then after that dot dot, so many things are there. After that, finally, Gopinath Acharya going to conclude that by proficiency, by your panditta, you can never understand Ishwar. Nayam atma pravachanena labhyo, na midhaya na bahuna sutena, jam eva esha vinita tena labhyo, jam eva esha vinita tena labhyo. When Bhagavan going to speak, well, he is my devotee, I accept him. Then and only then, aprakita vastu kabu prakita guchan nai. Aprakita vastu, forcefully you cannot understand. You cannot see, you cannot understand. If that aprakita vastu going to bestow mercy upon you and me, then and only then possible. Like when Mahaprabhu dancing in seven sampradaya at a time, simultaneously, in Purushottam Dham, in front of Jagannath Ratha, in seven sampradaya simultaneously, Mahaprabhu dancing, but nobody can see. Only by the desire of Gauranga, Jogmaya going to show, follow this picture, this transcendental picture. Sarvamataja can see, king can see, Prataprudhu and one on two, not everybody. That's why in our Jiva Goswami writing in Sandarbha, Bhagavan going to reserve this power of Sap Prakasita Shakti. Bhagavan going to reserve all power, and this power is Sap Prakasita, self-manifesting power, Shakti. It is called self-manifesting power. Follow. A self-manifesting power, when going to act by the desire of Gauranga, Jogamaya going to arrange everything, then only a few, like Gopinath Acharya, Raja, they can see the excellent Leela. Gauranga dancing simultaneously at seven sampradaya at a time, not everybody. Whereas Gauranga Mahaprabhu dancing. So if you try to see forcefully, you cannot see. So assumption is totally prohibited, logical interpretation I already told. So there it is written, we cannot come to any conclusion only by reading this sloka. Though we know aprakita vastu ko pakita kuchan nai, anuman praman nai, we know, we read, but still, when we are hearing Harikatha, we like to get some concrete document. This is the main thing. Blindly, we cannot pass any remark on any subject, be it material or spiritual. But it is my request to you everyone, everybody, whenever we like to understand something, before that, you will have to understand, you will have to think that I have my capacity to understand this thing or not. Like somebody fighting with me, if you can make me understand, if you can give me, if you can teach me, I can learn applied physics. I say, how it is possible? You are illiterate personality. First of all, you will have to start learning. You can go to, you know, school, after that, college, after the university. Then after that, you have this subject minimum, you know, qualification, then you can. So to understand any particular subject, to understand, suppose you are at the age of 65 or 70, then you like to understand the complexity of Sanskrit grammar. How it is possible? Not possible. So you cannot understand now, at present. So to understand something, minimum quality I have or not, that is the main. One example I can give from Shastra, it is given by Mahaprabhu. Follow. Like, if I say, so blindly we cannot pass any remark on any subject, be it material or spiritual. But minimum faith we should have, like you can remember he was speaking, when a small boy, he is going to start writing first. A, A, K, K, I mean A, B, C, D. Pandit coming, it is the usual system in our Vedic society. Pandit coming in Saraswati Puja day and going to help that boy to write A, B, C, D, then first writing. And if the small boy start fighting with Pandit, where is the document that it is A? Who told you it is A? Who told you it is B? I am not ready to accept it is A and B. If the small boy start fighting with this small issue, I am not ready to accept is A. Who told you it is A? What is the document? Then at all his spiritual, his you know education cannot go ahead. So without argument, when we are entering into spiritual world, spiritual world means bhajan. Spiritual world, actual spiritual world is far away. When we are going to step into you know bhajan field, minimum thing what Guru Vaishnava at present speaking. We must accept it without any argument. Go on doing it. After that, you can understand gradually. Follow what I say. And if you are thinking about Chitar Guru, I am not speaking about Chitar Guru. I am speaking about Sadguru. Chitar Guru always. I am speaking about standard thing. So when Sadguru going to speak, my boy, you go on doing it first. After that, after some time, I can give you. At present, you cannot understand. You go on following my instruction, what I say. This way, minimum faith we should have to start our bhajan. After that, gradually, in course of our bhajan, Sadguru Vaishnava, surely, they are going to give us everything, all you can grow faith, everything. But argument is prohibited. Follow. Argument can throw you away from bhajan field. That is the facility you can get. Nothing else. Now I am going to give one example which was already given by Mahaprabhu. Follow. Gangayam Ghosapalli. Mahaprabhu giving the example. In front of Sarvamataja Mahaprabhu speaking Sarvabhauma. You want to prove. Sarvabhauma, you always want to prove this Bhagavan is impersonal. No hand, no leg, nothing, no eyes, nothing. But what is that? Well, it is written in Shastra. Where is it written? But Upanishad, Apanipadam. Okay, Apanipadam. But after that, what is written? Apanipadam javano grahitva pashyati srinati akarna. Pashyati achakshu srinati akarna. The first it is using there is no leg, no hay, no leg, no nose, nothing. Apani pada, no hand and no leg. But after that it is written, Bhagavan very swiftly, very fast running and going to take what you are going to offer by loveful attitude. If you want to offer something, Bhagavan javano grew very quickly. And he is watching everything without eyes. He is hearing everything without ear. What does it mean? Mapu wanted to establish Sarvabhauma. Actually, you are great Pandit. You are big Pandit, I know. You are big Pandit, you are Brihaspati. But you don't understand that here the meaning is that Bhagavan, like us, we have a material hand and leg and eyes and nose, everything material. And this in Napanipada it is written there, it is true. But apani mean, there is no hand leg mean, Bhagavan has no material hand and leg, everything. But aprakito hand and leg is rare. Aprakito hand and leg and everything there. Not only that, but also in Brahma Sangita it is written, Bhagavan can do anything with by the help of any sense organ. Indriyani yasya sakalendriya bhittimanti. What do you know? Indriyani yasya sakalendriya bhittimanti pashyanti panti kalayanti chiram jaganti. Follow what I say. It is written that Bhagavan can use any sense organ to do any job. Bhagavan can eat by eyes. We cannot believe. We are by, it is possible, Maharaj. You are speaking this. Why not possible? We know from Guru Bhargava it is possible. Only by darshan, Bhagavan can eat. Darshan bhog. Drishti bhog. Follow. Why not possible? Whereas in material world we have this kind of excellent diversity that a snake can hear without ear. A snake can hear without ear. How possible? Well, a snake, the name of snake, it is a sarpo, it is called, another name is there, that is Okshisrava. Srila Bharati Maharaj also used to give the example, I am also giving. Okshisrava. Okshiman, by the help of eyes, snake can hear anything. Really so? Yes. Snake, by the help of eyes, can see, both can see and hear. By the help of eyes, vibration coming, then it is going to translate, get translated into by eyes, eyeball, then snake can understand who is coming, going, everything. So it's possible. So in this material world itself, there is so big diversity, diversity, excellent. So why not possible? If a snake can hear by the help of eyes, and also by the help of eyes can hear and see, why not possible, Supreme Lord? That's mean you are Mayavadi. You are not ready to believe that Bhagavan can do anything, everything. So this way, Mahaprabhu going to speak in front of Sarvabhumo, any time when you are going to pass any judgment about any sentence or any exclusive word bearing some deep meaning, like Vedanta, you are giving me argument about Vedanta, but I find you are going to leave the direct meaning of Vedanta Sutra. Try to understand. Mahaprabhu directly speaking to Sarvabhumo, you are Pandit. But you don't understand. Vedanta Sutta written by Vedabhyas. Vedabhyas writing one sutra with some deep meaning. So you will have to go into deep meditation to understand the meaning of Vedanta Sutta. What Vedabhyas wanted to speak. So you will have to rely upon Vedabhyas. You will have to depend upon his mercy. Otherwise you cannot get meaning. Why? You are making different meaning. Follow. Vedanta Sutta, when you are going to read Vedanta Sutta, directly, read Sutra, then I understand. Mahaprabhu speaking to Sarvabhumo, when you read Vedanta directly, then I understand. Atoto Brahma Jigyasa. After that, Ikshetena Sabdam. Sastra Janitvat. I understand meaning. But you are going to make meaning in a different way. You are going to make meaning of this sutra, each sutra, different way. Totally different way. Totally different way. Why? Sarvam Vartaja, you become sentimental. Sarvam Vartaja, feelings, you are feeling. Why? Well, you are making meaning of Vedanta, but different way, not directly. What do you mean? Sarvabhumo, actually, point is that there is Lakhana and Avidha. In Shastra, we know when you are going to pass any remark, going to cast any commentary or make any meaning of any sutra, anything, there is two procedures. One is Lakshana, one is Avidya. Lakshana and Avidya. When directly it is impossible to understand the meaning of that sloka sutra, then you will have to make Lakshana. But when it is very clear, the meaning is very clear, why you are going to take trouble to go zigzag way? What do you mean? And I want to give one example. Mahaprabhu is going to give one example to Sarvabhumo. Gangayam Ghoshapalli. In Sanskrit, we see, in Sanskrit we can say, Mahaprabhu speaking, Gangayam Ghoshapalli. Follow. Gangayam Ghoshapalli, if you want to make direct meaning, if you want to get direct meaning, then it means that one village is there. It directly, if you like to get meaning, word to word meaning, then it means that there is one village, Gosha. There is one village of Gosha. Gosha means those who are dealing with cow and milk. Gosh, Gosh. There is one Ghoshapalli, I mean village, on Ganga. On Ganga. Hari? Gangayam Ghoshapalli surely does not mean that one village of Gosha is there on Ganga river. Because it cannot so happen. Because a village on Ganga, how it is possible? Ganga river is quite impossible. So the meaning should be that there is a village by the side of the bank of Ganga river. Mahaprabhu giving his one. Gangayam Ghoshapalli surely means that not on Ganga. Follow. So here direct meaning you cannot get. Lakshana your. So every time you cannot mean Lakshana. Whereas Mahaprabhu speaking, I can understand all the sloka, meaning of sloka, direct meaning when you are speaking sloka. When you are going to speak direct sloka, then I easily understand the meaning, what Vyasadeva wanted to speak. But when you are going to make meaning, then the real meaning is covered up. Then the real meaning is just covered up. I cannot understand. So after that Mahaprabhu went on giving this example, Apanipada, what does it mean? You know, Upanishad, this, that, Mahaprabhu all wanted to give example. This way actually, Bhagavan has upraked the hands and leg, everything. Everything is possible. There. What is not possible? Follow. Now, up to this point, I first discuss that we will have to depend upon Kripa. Now I can go back to my original point that Bhaktivinoda Thakur wanted to explain the position of Tathastha Jiva from Brihad Aranyaka Upanishad. From Brihad Aranyaka Upanishad, Mahaprabhu wanted to choose two sloka. Even Baladev Vidyavasana, everybody, they are going to give this example. Bhaktivinoda Thakur, our Guru Varga, everybody, they are going to give this example. And by the help of this example, somehow we can understand the position of Tathastha Jiva. First of all, try to understand. Because almost 1 year back, in 2019, March, I think, April, March, I don't know, I will have to check up. I was discussing in detail about this Jiva Tattva, so many things I was speaking, but really I was not ready to speak about the secret thing. Because sometime those who are doing bhajan, they have so fickle mind, if I speak directly, they can break their conception. They cannot understand. So I wanted to hide for the time being. That's why I told, first of all, try to understand up to this point. After that, my discussion is not complete. Sometime in future, I can also discuss. I told you, you can remember. I was giving this example when Ramanujacharya, Vishishta Dvaitabad, and Madhvacharya giving something, Dvaita Dvaitabad, so many arguments there. But finally I told, each and every spiritual leader, big, Ramanujacharya, not ordinary personality, Madhvacharya, not ordinary, but they all coming from their Bhagavan going to depute them to execute some special job up to certain point. They are going to establish Siddhanta up to certain point, not fully. Everybody, all the four acharyas, the four sampradayas, they are They are coming in this material world according to the desire of Supreme Lord to establish some special thing. Follow. After that, over. Even I can give the example of Chaitanya Bhagavat, Vrindavan Das Thakur Mahasaya. Krishna Das Kaviraj Goswami is speaking, Vrindavan Lilar Bas, Vrindavan, Chaitanya Lilar Bas, Vrindavan Das. Vrindavan Das Thakur Mahasaya is the Vyasadeva of Chaitanya Lila. How it is possible that Vyasadeva not knowing all Lila of Chaitanya Deva? It's impossible. So, Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami giving argument with full of devotional argument. This is not dry argument. He is speaking, maybe out of his mercy he is going to keep something for me. I am all the time, when Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami is speaking, I am chewing uchishta. I am chewing uchishta of Vrindavan Das Thakur Mahasaya. Be sure about it. I am always chewing uchishta of Vrindavan Das Thakur Mahasaya. I never like to make any offense at Lotus Vrindavan Das. By the mercy of Vrindavan Das Thakur Mahasaya, if he is going to allow me to write something, he is going to keep some prasadam for me to write, I can do it. Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami never going to express, you know, attitude like Vallabhacharya in front of Mahaprabhu. Well, I cannot accept the commentary of Sridhar Saipad, so I am bound to write. What do you say? What do you mean? Eh? What do you mean? You don't understand? You don't like to accept Sridhar Saipad? You pros? Mahapur speaking, Swami nahi mane tare beshamadgi. Who is not going to accept Sridhar Saipad is surely his pros. He was shocked. Oh my God, Supreme Lord is very... You know, he was very angry to see this kind of, you know, false ego. Oh, how dare you speak that way, eh? Is Sidharam Betti Nishinga Pasadat. By the mercy of Nishingadev, Sridhar Goswami Pad going to know the all meaning of Bhagavatam. But Bhagavatam is no other than Supreme Lord. Supreme Lord, so from different angle, one commentator can write. Like we know, Vijay Raghav writing, Vishwanath Chakravarti writing, Jiva Goswami Pad writing, Sanatana Goswami Pad writing, you know, Vallabha. Mahapur was very angry. So on Bhagavatam is like, you know, a prakita diamond. From different angle, if you look, different kind of meaning can come out. That's why Mahaprabhu was bound to give this kind of excellent example. 62 different kind of meanings of one Bhagavad Sloka. Atma Ramascha Manayo Nirgantha Upi Urukrame Kurvanti Ahetuking Bhaktim Itvam Mitugunaha Hari. Mahaprabhu gave 62 different kind of meaning, you know. Mahaprabhu speaking, Bhagavatam is just Krishna, no other than Krishna. So from different angle, if you look, different kind of meaning can come out. But that doesn't mean a Mayavadi can also make separate meaning. I am speaking about those who are Bhakti Acharyas. Those different Bhakti Acharyas, they can pass commentary, write commentary, is possible. But that doesn't mean one Mayavadi can also write. They cannot see that Advaita Gyan Tattva perfectly. They are Mayavadi. They are going to deny the existence of any Shakti Tata with Supreme Lord. They like to prove that Brahma is neutral gender. Brahma has no hand, nothing. They want to make this foolish, number one. So this way, Bhakti Tata Acharyas, they can have meaning from different angles. And those who are great acharyas, they can get harmony, total harmony. So the commentary written by Sridhar Saipad is very good. And Vishwanath Chakravarti Pad never going to cut their Siddhanta. He is writing, Sridhar Saipad writing with full respect. Sridhar Saipad writing this way. So on the basis of that tikka, that commentary, everybody going to write. Okay. Now Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami not going to express any false ego. He's going, how I can write? I'm just going to chew Uchishta given by Vrindavan Das Chakramasa. But in practically, if we see, if we go through Chaitanya Charitamrita, we can find it exclusive. Exclusive thing. Chaitanya Charitamrita means it is complete. Vrindavan Das Chakur Mahasaya, as per the decision of Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami, Vrindavan Das Chakur Mahasaya could write everything. But by causeless mercy, he is going to leave something for me so that I can also chew and take prasadam. This way, Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami writing. So I cannot say that. I cannot say that Ramanujacharya is wrong. I cannot say that Madhvacharya wrong. As per the decision of Mahaprabhu, there is some shortage. One going to admit Shakti Tattva, one existence of Supreme Lord, eternal existence. One is Shakti Tattva, one is this, that. But Mahaprabhu wanted to make all complete by the help of that four acharyas, Siddhanta. Mahaprabhu speaking, they anyhow wanted to establish Bhakti Siddhanta anyway. Anyway, they all wanted to establish Bhakti Siddhanta. But if we can understand Achinta Vedavet Tattva, then all their Siddhanta can be complete. We cannot say Ramanujacharya was foolish. So up to that point he was ordered. So Vrindavan Das Chakur Mahasaya coming here, he is himself Vyasadeva. Kavi Karnapur writing, he is himself Vyasadeva and Kusumapida Sakha, one friend, Krishna's one friend, coming and getting entry into heart. Both of them combined, this is called Vrindavan Das Chakur. Vrindavan Das Chakur is Vyasadeva himself. Vyasadeva, that Vyasadeva, yes, yes. Krishna Dvaipayan Vyasadeva, at the same time Kusumapida Sakha is already submerged there. And both of them combined, we can find is Vrindavan Das Chakur Mahasaya. So Vrindavan Das Chakur Mahasaya can never write wrong. Vrindavan Das Chakur can never write incomplete thing. But only this tax, this seva was left for Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami. Follow. All Chaitanya Leela is open in front of the Chid Lochan, transcendental eyes of Vrindavan Das Chakur. He could write everything, but some seva was left. Now, there is some argument about this point. Why Bhaktivinoda Thakur going to give this example? What is that example? That example from Bihad Bhagavatamrita, first, I can go to Vedanta also. So many sloka from Vedanta I can discuss by all your mercy to prove that karma anadi, how karma anadi, I can give portal under the guidance of Bilad Baladev Vidyavasan, Vishwanath Chakravarti, Jiva Goswami Pad, you know, all. Bhaktivinoda Thakur. So now we are busy here because it will take long time. Day after day we'll have to discuss this point. Not one day. You will have to remember. One thing I can repeat sometime, but not always. I know. Tasho va etasho purushasho de eva sthane bhavato idancho paraloko sthanancho sandhyam titiyam sapna sthanam. It is written. Tasmin sandhi sthane tishtan eti ubhe sthane pashyati idancha paraloka sthanancha. Bihad Bhagavatamrita 4.3.9. Follow. Another sloka, give an example here. 4.3.18. From Bihad Bhagavatamrita, Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing, tad yatha mahamatso ubhe kule अनुसंचरति पुरवंचापरंचैव मेवायम पुरुषो एतौ उभौ अन्त्वानुसंचरति स्वप्नान्तञ्च बुद्धान्तञ्च फॉलो वर एस ए दिस टू एग्जाम्पल गिविंग एनादर बृहदभागवतम बृहद फ्रॉम एंड बृहद आरण्यक उपनिषद एनादर एग्जाम्पल गिविन बाय भक्तिविनोद ठाकुर बृहद आरण्यक 2.1.10 यथाग्नेहे क्षुद्रा विस्फुलिंगा बुच्चरंती एवं मेवास्मद आत्मनः .. सर्वाणी भूतानि बुच्चरंती फलो यथाग्नेहे क्षुद्रा विस्फुलिंगा बुच्चरंती एवं एवास्मद आत्मनः .. सर्वाणी भूतानि बुच्चरंती Follow what I say. It's very important. Now, actually, this is to Bhaktivinoda Thakur, 439 and 4318, this in Jaiva Dharma, it is written actually there. And are taken these two verses quoted by Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur 439-4318 from Bihad Bhagavatamrita, you know, is taken by Bhaktivinoda out of context of what this chapter in Brihad Aranyak Upanishad is about, and that this proves that Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur only used these two verses taken out of context to support his preaching strategy. Follow. That one sannyasi told this way, it is not totally false, it is okay, because bonded soul anyhow cannot understand this aprakita vishaya. So Bhaktivinoda Thakur anyhow wanted to give two examples to help us understand something. Otherwise Bhattajib can blame Supreme Lord, because they don't know how karma is anadi, how bandhati eternally bandha. They can held Bhagwan is you know, have some partiality, this, that. So anyhow, Bhagwan, it is actually, you know, it is said that this third chapter of four of Bihad Bharanyak Upanishad is not about origin of jiva, because origin how we can say, there is no beginning. I can prove from Vedanta. And not about the origin of jiva, about marginal position of jiva prior to bondage. It is written, the point is, as I already wrote in my second question to you, he is writing to me, that the sannyasi who was arguing with me said that this third chapter of part 4 of Bihad Aranyaka Upanishad is not about origin of jiva, or about marginal position of jiva prior to bondage, or about starting point of jiva's bondage, but is about discussing the three stages of consciousness of already bonded jiva. Follow what I say. The point is, as I already wrote in my second question to you, that sannyasi who was arguing with me said that this third chapter of part 4 of Brihad Aranyaka Upanishad is not about origin of jiva, or about marginal position of jiva prior to bondage, or about starting point of jiva's bondage, but it is about discussing the three stages of consciousness of already bonded jiva. As for example, the state of wakefulness, the state of dream, and the state of dreamless sleep. Follow what I say. If one sees whole context with other verses of this chapter, one can see that it is discussing about these three stages: dream, dreamless sleep, and wakefulness of already bonded jiva. It is not false, right, that I can prove. Actually, for already bonded jiva, all those arguments, all those argument giving, actually, all those argument giving already follow. Already bonded jiva about. So now actually point is that in Jaiva Dharma, Bhaktivinoda Thakur giving some, because in Bhaktivinoda Thakur you know there is one Babaji Maha, Raghunath Das Baba, and also in the beginning we find Paramahansa Baba. Also here question answer going on, Brajanath putting question, he is giving answer. You know, there this way argument giving one by one, I am going to discuss. Jatha agnehe khudra vispulinga vuchparanti, this meaning I am speaking. Just as innumerable sparks coming out of a fireplace, similarly from Sri Krishna, who is the absolute Atma, the universal soul, those jivas who are his separated part and parcels emanate. You know, follow. Mamaiva amsa jiva loke jiva bhuto sanatanaha. This. Follow. The jiva has access in two places, both of which may be possible actually, material world. And what I mean to say, the jivatma tatastha jiva, jiva shakti. I already told many times, tatastha shakti, jiva shakti has no directly Bhagavan, not inside Bhagavan. It is with Bhagavan. Shakti is there with Bhagavan, but not directly inside, because inside Bhagavan there is no allow, only sarv shakti. It is there with somehow with Bhagavan, but not direct inside heart of Supreme Lord. Inside there is only sarv shakti, no, nobody allow, no shakti other. So this jiva tatasa shakti is suitable for both the place. One is material world, another is spiritual realm. She is situated in the sapna sthanam, just like it's compared with dream. What to speak about dream? Tatastha position, you can also remember, if you understand. I am not going to give you the, but still this example is very effective. Suppose you are doing bhajan, you are not siddha, sometime you are taking decision to do bhajan very perfectly, next day you are, you know, going to jump into maya. Follow, I am giving this plain example. I know you are very good, you are writing question to me, Maharaj, sometime I get inspiration, sometime not getting, why not getting? You can see your mind, my question is that, you can see your mind, nobody can see mind. Mind can never be seen, but you can feel that mind is there. You cannot touch your brain, but you can see that brain is there, intellect. So your mind itself, you know, sometime running this way, that way. Follow what I seem to say. Sometimes you are thinking positively, sometimes you are thinking negatively. It depends upon your bhajan state. Sometimes you are doing aparad, going back, again coming forward. It depends upon your situation. According to your situation of your bhajan, you are going back and coming forward. So, prachodaya, that mantra, what you are, is, if you are, when you are going to hold, when you are going to hold your positive, you know, position, then surely you can feel one power coming from Supreme Lord, prachodaya. But when you are going to feel negative, that time you can feel you are not going getting power. Also, it can be compared with yana-tata-sabhaji, your mind oscillating. Sometimes this side, sometimes that side. Many questions coming, you don't understand how it is possible. If you have a basic idea about mathematics, basic idea, 1, 2, 3, 4, you write right-hand side, you write minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, but anyway, you are bound to put one zero in between. Because without crossing zero, negative integer cannot, you know, cross zero. It is always there. Follow. From negative position, if you like to go to positive side, you will have to cross over this zero first. If you can come to zero, mean it's neutral position, tatastha position. From there, if you go positive side, then 1, 2, 3, 4, you can go ahead. Follow. If you are going to negative direction, then also you will have, like the case of Ajamil I give you. Ajamil was not doing perfect bhajan. But anyway, some preliminary faith is there. Brahman, Vaishnav, elderly person, senior personalities. He was habituated to do salgam sila. He was offering tulsi and flowers, everything. But how it was possible for Ajamil to fall down? I already told, by the mercy of Sadguru, if you are going to get big power, enough power, because without Guru, you cannot go. Siksha Guru, Disha Guru, all depend upon Guru. How much power you are going to get from Guru, it will depend upon that issue. So Ajamil was surely in positive side, because his character was not bad, he is good. At least you can say this positive side, not doing so big bhajan. I have some faith in, you know, Guru, Vaishnav, Salagram, this they are doing. But how it was possible for him to fall down? And what was the situation when he was in fall down condition? First of all, if you understand, he was in positive side. By the mercy of Guru Vishnu, we can understand this point. When he was in positive side, I mean, he was not doing perfect bhajan, but still, he was doing something. Not at least negative thing he was not doing. Oscillating mind. Bonded soul is always tatastha position, oscillating. Bonded condition. So in that case, Ajamil could not check himself. Ajamil could not check himself in front of Maya. When he saw that Maya, he was unable to check himself. So naturally he is going to lose his everything, ethical character, everything, and is going to fall down. Because Maya is drizzling. You know, Maya has some power, Maya is going to envelop Ajamil fully. Previously he was not. Yeah, some Maya was there a little bit. But anyhow he was in little bit positive side. But now he fell down. Follow. By the mercy of that Vishnu Dut, you can remember there was some discourse between Vishnu Dut and Yamaduta. And Ajamil had the facility to hear all this discussion. Ajamil, when Yamaduta came to take away that Jivatma, you know, that time immediately when Ajamil was speaking Narayana, immediately Vishnudut coming, wanted to help him. But that time there was some argument, discussion going on. That is Harikatha. By the mercy of this Vishnudut, Vaikuntha Parshad, the Harikatha, I mean about the excellent glories of Harinam, Ajamil had the chance to hear. And Jamaduta all gone. Then he was feeling little bit okay. After that, by the mercy of Satsanga, and in between for long time, he was speaking in the name of his son Narayan. Come here, Narayan, go, Narayan, Narayan, eat. Anyway, willingly or unwillingly, he was pronouncing Narayan. It is so many arguments there, I don't like to touch it. Now, basically I am speaking. This way, Ajamil was in negative position, but by the mercy of that Vaikuntha Parsad, again he crossed this, you know, tatastha position, when a favorable position. Ajamil now, you know, in a favorable position, he was left by Vishnudut, and now he was calculating how to get highest benefit, Mangal. Then he leave home, leaving the association of that cross, and after that, you know, doing bhajan. Ajamil opi agad damam. Ajamil also went to dam. How it is possible? They don't know. After hearing Harikatha, Vishnudut going to leave him. So he was getting enough chance to do bhajan, to rectify himself. Again, then after that, he was Ajamil opi agad damam. Ajamil also went to dam. How it is possible? Ajamil was fallen, so that this way it was possible. So negative, positive, both were there. In between, zero is a must. Zero, you will have to cross. Either way, if you can go from this way to that side, from this side to that side. So, Tatastha Jiva is suitable for both material world and spiritual realm. That Tatastha Jiva is, you know, situated in Swapna Sthanam, like dream. The dream, like third state, on the margin of these two worlds, though it is not, you cannot say it is, you know, fictitious, it is false. Bhaktivinoda Thakur not writing without any base. Baseless writing Bhaktivinoda Thakur cannot write. So there is some ground. Tatastha, like you cannot see your mind. But that doesn't mean mind is not there with you. You cannot find any tatastha position in this material world. Anywhere you go in infinity bunda, there is no such position as tatastha position. That's why you can remember Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing from Brihadaranyaka Upanishad this way. Same Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing more clearly. Follow, those who are elevated devotee, for them Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing that tatastha Babaji, you know, in sarupa of jiva, tatastha bhava is there secretly. But Baddhajiva is never tatastha. Baddhajiva is always bound. Follow. Bhaktivinoda Thakur, same Bhaktivinoda Thakur, I think I can give you number of sloka, this, that, you know. Chaitanya Charitamrita, middle khanda, you know, 24, chapter 283, sloka. Sloka also I can read if you like to see it. It is written in a sloka, it is in a written, ... Nitya Siddho Parishad Das, Shakha Guru Kantagon Charivido Prakas. In the Amrita Prabhava Asya Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing, in Sarupa, Tatastha Bhav is there very secretly inside Jiva. But Baddha Jiva is never Tatastha. They are always Maya, under the influence of Maya. Now, one by one, I can try to prove from Upanishad, Vedanta, detailed discussion, it will take a long time. Try to keep patience. 100% I can prove by the mercy of Prabhupada Bhaktivinoda Thakur Guru Varga. You will have to keep patience. You know, this way, if you see, This example, you cannot see your mind, but you are bound to believe that you have your mind. Similar way, tatastha position you cannot see, but tatastha position is already there, 100%. But it can be compared with these two sloka. Tasho vai tasho purushasya deva sthane. It can be compared. It is very suitable. That's why Bhaktivinoda Thakur wanted to give easily, wanted to give these two or three examples, so that minimum we can have some minimum idea about what is tatastha position. That's why. From the middle position, tatastha position, tatastha jiva is able to see both material and spiritual world. The example giving from Brihadaranyaka Upanishad. Further, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, when going to give this example, tad yatha maha matsyo uhe kule this sloka, the symptoms, I mean the example can be compared with a very, very big ocean or river where the big fish sometime, you know, swimming here and this side of, sometime coming this side of the river or ocean and going that side. Follow. This side and that side is swimming across, you know. This example is giving very, very nicely so that minimum conception, bonded soul can go some minimum about this tattva vigyan. Otherwise they can, like blind, they can hover, where is tattva, where is this tattva, we don't understand. That's why Bhaktivinoda Thakur is bound to give this example in front of us, nothing else. Now actually, Bhaktivinoda Thakur giving these two examples going to make us understand that how, you know, thought mean is a common point between water and land. Brajana going to other tatasasadir vaidantik artha ki, what is the actual meaning of tatastha about according to Vedanta darshan. Follow. First of all, Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing, the countless atomic particles, chit particles, they are coming just like rays of the sun is giving it. And after that, Brajana is asking, what is the tatastha sabhav? What is the tatastha sabhav? Tatastha sabhav, what is this tatastha sabhav? What is this? I don't understand. Then Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing, the jiva is situated in the middle portion with access of both the worlds. And this jiva is, you know, continuously, you know, susceptible to come under the control of either of Shaktis. This condition is symptomatic of the tatastha sabhava. When the movement of river water shift the bank of a river, this seizes the land and covers it into riverbed. Alternatively, you know, this way going on, this, you know, Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing that they can have the chance to look both way, both side, one is chit jagat, one is maya jagat. Tatastha jiva can come under the influence of maya, also can go that side, I mean chit jagat. Follow? This way one demarcation line, imagination, you will have to imagine. That day I was speaking, one thing, that day one example I was giving, if you remember is good, that remember you can remember, I was giving this example, it is just like, you know, just like ideal gas of physics chemistry. Ideal gas of physics chemistry, actually there is, you know, ideal gas of physics chemistry, you can understand. You can understand this point. There is no such line. In, you know, practically you cannot find. Practically you can never find. Practically you can never find. Where is this, you know? But still, if you try to understand, on the basis of the idea, on the basis of this conception of ideal gas, without ideal gas, you cannot have the scope to calculate. You cannot calculation, you cannot do in chemistry and physics. Also, on the basis of this conception, you know, those jivatmas are part and parcel of Supreme Lord Krishna and manifestation of His marginal potency. So naturally those, you know, jiv, chit particles are having both way tendency. They can be attracted by Maya Jagat, they can be attracted by Chit Jagat, you know. This, on the basis of this conception of a marginal line of demarcation, on the basis of this conception of marginal line of demarcation, one line has been conceived. Follow, in between the transcendental world and material world, which is not at all found in, which is not at all found in this material world. Material form you cannot find. But the conception is not wrong. Which is not practically you can find in this world. At the same time, which is not at all 100% false. It is not at all false. The conception is right. Though you cannot trace out any place, tatastha position where all jivatma they are jumping, you cannot. Because originally, there is no beginning. From Vedanta, we can show Baladev Vidyabhushan going to prove argument. I know. First, this party going to speak this, that party going to speak. Just like the conception of ideal gas has been, you know, accepted in physics and chemistry, as per the standard of Kelvin scale, the ideology is very, very important. This ideological conception can help us to realize the marginal condition of Jivatma. We know it for sure that Supreme Lord, eternally present, and those eternally present, and those infinitesimal, infinity, jivatmas, chira, you know, jivatmas, all jivas are all also eternally present. No doubt in it. But how and when those jivas become bahirmukh, that is the main question. We have to find answer. Krishna Bhuli, in Chaitanya Chaitanya, it is written, Krishna Bhuli, say jiv anadi bahirmukh. Now question is how and when. This question, because no starting point we can find. Because those jivas, bonded, you know, jivas we can find in two stage, anadi bahirmukh and anadi unmukh. Anadi unmukh, those who are serving Supreme Lord. You can remember, those jivas was coming from Baladev Sankarsan, they eternally doing seva, they are mukta, eternally mukta. They never have any experience about maya. So they are doing eternal seva in eternal world. And other jivas, you know, they are just equal to Baladev, like Sridham, Sudham, Vasudham. I am not speaking about them. Those mukta jivas, coming, emanating from Sankarsan Baladev, eternally present there. And another group, eternally bahirmukh. And two stage we can condition. One is bonded condition, know, bonded condition, two status, like liberated condition, eternally liberated, they are eternally present there, and bonded condition, the ideological conception of tatastha bhava of jiva is also present in superfine form in the itself in the swarup of jiva, but this doesn't indicate a third stage of jiva's existence. Only two, one is nitya mukta, one is nitya baddha. Nitya baddha, nitya mukta, only these two stages, categories can be found. And the third stage, marginal, is only positive conception on the basis of which it can be easily understood the constitutional position of jivatma. But it is not false. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, it is already there. Bhaktivinoda Thakur also wanted to prove that we in bonded condition, we have our material body and, you know, gross body and subtle body, and Atma, Chidatma is there inside. But Bhaktivinoda Thakur also going to speak that like Chidatma is there already, and by under the covering of both, you know, fine body and gross body. Gross body and subtle body. Chidatma is already there. Similarly, Bhaktivinoda Thakur is going to speak that Tatastha Sakti, Tatastha Bhava is already there in the Chit Saru of Jiva. But Chit body, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, when we can discover the Chit body, that Chit body, like we have our limbs, hand, leg, nose, everything, very beautiful. Very nice, na? Bhaktivinoda Thakur can prove that those Chidatma inside of body, they are also having one nice body of Chit body. And inside that Chit body, there is an eternal Sarup of Jiva. Mane specific. Ultimately, I can prove that Jiva Sarup, how fixed. That ultimately I can speak at the end of conclusion. Now we are going to discuss about these two points, how it is possible. How it is possible that those jivas, they are, you know, this, you know, how it is possible that. So now, what is the tatastha sarupa marginal nature of jivas? The jiva is situated in middle with across to both worlds, and jivatma is constitutionally, you know, susceptible to come under the control of either of Shaktis. And I know, can come Maya Shakti, and they can Chit potency also, they can go, you know, this way. Bhaktivinoda Thakur wanted to prove that when they are looking both sides, they are looking both sides, sometimes feeling attraction this side, they can come, because they are watching in bonded condition. It is the condition of bonded condition. Because another question came in your letter, that if at all there is option, and if we at all can find one position where Tathasati is resting, and at all they have the scope to watch both the side, then surely when they are going to look Krishna all attractive, surely they are not going to jump into Maya. Though different kind of example you are giving, you know, this example is applicable for bonded soul. Because inside bonded soul also, they are fluctuating conditions. Sometimes they are thinking good, sometimes thinking. You are giving the example of, I also give, sometimes giving the example of fire. Inside fire, some insects jumping. Inside fire, some insects jumping. You are giving the example. Your Gurudev told, okay, but complete discussion was not there. It is about already bonded soul. Already in bonded soul, jeeps sometime thinking positively, thinking negatively, both ways thinking. That time, not about before bonded condition, because bondage condition eternal. So there is no at all, there was no option. There was no at all, there was no option. The option here in Brihad, you know, Aranya Upanishad already given. A dream said this, that, all already about bonded soul. Not Tathastha soul, Bandajiv is not at all Tathastha, already there, you know, Baddha. Mitya Mukta, Nitya Baddha, two categories you can find. You know, Nitya Baddha, Nitya Mukta, both category you can find, nothing else. So, try to digest. Also, I can speak about eternal time factor there, in eternal, but after, not that. Now I am dealing with this, how bonded soul become Baddha. How bonded soul become Baddha, this question is absolutely wrong. Because Jiva is eternally Baddha. Eternally they are Baddha. So no question, when and how it is possible, not eternally. Now, question is that we can fight with Krishna. Why Krishna doing this way? Why Krishna, from Vedanta Sutra, we can, one or two point I can discuss today, and after that, maybe tomorrow I can discuss again. In Vedanta Sutra, 2.1.32, na prayana bhattvadhikaranam. In Vedanta Sutta, na prayana bhattvadhikaranam. Here it is written, na prayana bhattvat. A sutra, formula only. Na prayana bhattvat. What do you mean? If we like to get direct meaning of the sutra, it means na prayana bhattvat mean prayana hinatar janna, without any necessity. There is no reason on the part of Brahma. There is no reason on the part of Brahma, so that Brahma is going to create this world. Then why is creating? So no prayana bhattvat. Prayajan hinata, there is no necessity. He is himself saturated. Supreme Lord is himself complete. No dissatisfaction, nothing can give inspiration so that he can start karma. I mean, he can create this Brahma. So, there is no ground on the basis of which Brahma can start creation, this Srishti Leela. This is the main direct reading. Because Supreme Lord is itself Purna, there is no dissatisfaction, nothing. Aprayanavatvat. You know, follow. There is no necessity. One example I can give from Shastra, that why Joy Vijay was sent here. Why? What can be the reason? What can be the reason? Joy Vijay, their eternal person. Their eternal person. So, what is the reason for why Joy Vijay was bound to fall down here? So many disturbance we are feeling. We have suspicion, doubt, that Maharaj in Gita it is already written, Jatgatta non divartante tadhyamam paramamamo. We already know, after going to Chiddham, Aprakita Jabat, nobody is supposed to fall down. Then why fall down? Then in the comment to Vishwanatha Chakravarti, we are writing that Bhagavan already giving answer. When Chatuswan going to beg for pardon, that we had done some mistake, please, you know, how we become angry and give. Bhagavan said, no. It is according to my desire. Your desire? Yes. According to my desire, it was done. It was one kind of lila. Now Joy Vijay was crying, Bhagavan speaking, you see. You know, directly and indirectly, everything done by Supreme Lord. So the curse given by Chatusam is also one kind of Bhagavan speaking. That you're giving curse to them, it is my approval. Sitting inside your heart, I was giving inspiration, gift cards. Why? Vishwanath Chakravarti was speaking that Jai Vijay, Vaikuntha Parsad, they are never supposed to come down here, and surely Vaikuntha Badi, Chinmay Parsad Badi, Jai Vijay is Parsad Badi, Chinmay, eternal Parsad Badi. How it is possible for them to fall down here? Bale Maharaj, actually point is there, they never fall down. Yes. They never fall down. Actually, by the yogic power, they have yogic power. By yogic power, they are going to take very, very, like Hanumanji Maharaj. When going to Asak Kanan in Mahabharat, Lanka, in Sri Lanka, when going to Asak Kanan to meet with Sita Devi, taking the form of a fly, very small fly, is possible. Anima, Logima, Prakama, Kamo, everything possible. So by the desire of Krishna, they are bound to come down here. But surely, they are not going to throw their eternal body, Parsad body. Parsad body already there, but taking very fine form. Very, to enter into the womb of Diti Ma, so that they can take a new body like demon, Hiranyakasipu Hiranyaksha. Follow. Hiranyakasipu Hiranyaksha. It was by the desire of Krishna. Now question coming, how desire coming? You already told they are saturated, there cannot be any desire. Okay, there cannot be any desire, but still there can be desire. Everything can get at all proper adjustment. Krishna is topmost. Krishna is having topmost detachment. Krishna is having topmost detachment. Nobody can. Vairagyasya, aisajyasya, samagyasya, vijyasya, jasasya, sriya, jnana vairagyasya, saro iti, bhaga ingana. The vairagya already there. Who can start competition with Chaitanya Mahaprabhu when he took sannyas? Who can go into competition with Krishna when he is doing Rasa Leela? Both the pictures, same Supreme Lord. So we'll have to understand the inner meaning. And the depth, what is Rasa Leela? It is not dirty, that I already discussing. Now point is that all two contradictory points can get total adjustment, very nice adjustment in that transcendental world. Bhagavan is no, you know, desire, but still, Bhagavan wanted to enjoy. What kind of enjoy? Bir rasa, fighting with one mind. And who can fight except Vaikuntha Parsad? No material man can fight, because Vaikuntha Parsad is just equal to Bhagavan. They can fight. Follow what I say. Why Pitamaha Vishwa is Dadas one of these 12 Mahajan? Why Pitamaha Vishwa going to throw arrow on the body of Krishna, whereas blood coming out? Vishwanath Chakravarti was giving argument, discussion. Pitamaha Vishwa, very nice argument. Very nice argument. Pitamaha Vishwa is number one devotee of Krishna. Are devotee, then why is going to throw arrow? You know, blood coming out. Vishwanath Chakravarti speaking, like when hero and heroine going to love each other, they become fanatic love affair. They are going to cut blood coming out of hero. Still it is enjoyment. Vishwanath Chakravarti giving this example. When hero and heroine going to love each other fanatic way, nobody knows what he is doing. Then after that, they can cut each other with nail and teeth, but still it is very, 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 very nice sensitive enjoyment. Vishnu Chakrabarti speaking, though blood coming out, be sure we should not express any doubt about Pitama Vishwa. He is a great devotee. But he was bound to do according to the desire of Krishna. Krishna wanted to also get this kind of, according to desire of Krishna. Because Bhagavan, I can prove that Bhagavan speaking, those who are my devotee, sometime if they are going to do some negative, maybe, you know, purposely they are doing, I am playing with them. But for bonded soul, I am not there directly. As Paramatma, in dormant state inside all jivas, Paramatma is there, who can deny? Paramatma is already there inside all jivas. But Bhagavan speaking, inside devotees I am relaxing. I am openly saying. Whereas Bhagavan going to speak that according to their, you know, I am doing everything according to, you know, what to do, what not to do, I am doing. Vishwanath Chakravarti was writing commentary, this is my general rule, I am equal to all jivatma, I am equal to all. I have surely no partiality. Je jathaman prapadyante tam sativa bhajamyam. Je jathaman, man prapadyante, I am also going to fulfill. But my special rule is there, those who are going to think about me all the time, what to do? Ananas chintayanto ye yanaman parjubhasate tesam nittabhi yuktanam yogokhyam abhahamyam. It is my special rule. I can go on discussing about the bonded condition, bonded jiva, everything, eternal time, everything I can go on discussing. Everything I can, long time, it will take long time. It will take long time. We can go on discussing about, follow. So now you see, about bonded jiva, Vyasadeva Goswami already writing, with this I can finish today. Nasto prayasi abhadresu, this sloka you can discuss. Also, follow. Or I can start tomorrow. Sinnatam sa kathaha krishna punnasavana kirtanaha hiddantusto hi avadrani vidanoti svetsatam. Nasto prayasi abhadresu nittam bhagavat sevaya bhagavati uttam sloke bhaktir bhavati nashtiki. Tada rajastam bhavaha kamo lobhadayascha je cheto etoir anavidhyam. Sthitam satte prasidati. I can discuss tomorrow to show the condition of bonded soul. And evam prasanna manaso bhagavat bhakti yogataha bhagavat tattva vijnanam mukta sangasya pariyat jayate. Follow what I say. Try to remember this sloka, I can discuss tomorrow, not today. You know, nasto prayasya abhadreshu nittam bhagavata sevaya bhagavati uttama sloke bhaktir bhavati nashtiki tada rajastam bhavaha kama lobhadayascha je cheto etair anavidhyam sittam satte prasidati evam prasanna manaso bhagavad bhakti yogataha bhagavat tattva vijnanam mukto sangasya pariyayate vancha kalpataru sikhi pasindu vavacha patitanam pavana bhavishnabhyo namah.